Welcome everyone, I'm Luis Leyva. Today I'm going to bring you up to speed with all the new business news and economy news, everything you need to know to make sure you're making all the right educated decisions in today's economy. So let's get started with the first piece of information I want to bring to light. The PPP loan has received some updates recently, some changes that are going into effect this week once Donald J. Trump signs off, but it looks like he's going to go ahead and do that. Let me explain to you what that means for you as a business owner. So number one, the time in which you can actually use that money to make payroll has been extended from 8 weeks to 24 weeks. That brings us into the end of the year, which is huge for a lot of people because they didn't have sufficient payroll in those 8 weeks to meet that. So this is good news, really, really great news for a lot of business owners who have taken out the PPP or have are thinking about taking out the PPP loan. This is a real good advancement. The other significant change that they've made is that now you do not need to spend 75% of the loan on payroll. It has been reduced down to 60% of the loan only has to be used for payroll. That's a big change. That's a big change because the other expenses that you're allowed to actually use the money for, number one would be rent, and then you would have the mortgage for your business if your business has a piece of property in which it utilizes for its operations. You can use it for the mortgage on that, you can use it for utilities, and you can use it for interest payments on loans. So this is a big change. Some people will still try to maximize the amount of money they use on payroll, but if you don't have that much payroll and you have other expenses, this is a good change for you. Now, believe it or not, there's a lot of business groups out there who are still fighting to try to expand the expenses you can use this on. So knowing now that we have 24 months in which we can use this for payroll and we don't have to use it all right away, it does give us a little bit of more time to see if we're able to extend this loan into other things that people may use, such as working capital, day-to-day expenses, and those types of things. So we're yet to hear about that, but we'll see soon. The other thing is that the deadline to rehire has been pushed back, so you don't have to rehire people by June 30th. You now have until December 31st to rehire people. And the rehire requirements have also changed. If you're unable to rehire people for one reason or another, as long as it meets their standards, you're good to go. If there's an inability to rehire people for whatever reason that may be, and if you have less business than you had before, you're not going to be obligated to pay all that money back. If you want more information, I'm actually going to link it down below in the description, the entire amendment that's been made, or addendum, amendment, whichever one you prefer to say, down below in the description section so you can read all the changes for yourself. Also, the repayment period is no longer going to be 2 years. You're going to have up to 5 years to make these repayments back. And there's talks of even maybe making this a little bit longer, but we'll see. 5 years is what they're talking about right now. If you want to know how much you'll be forgiven for, I'm going to leave down below in the description section also some calculators to see how much you can actually get approved for and forgiven for. So that's a big help for a lot of people who are confused about, hey, how much of this $50,000, $100,000 loan am I actually going to be forgiven for? So I'll leave that down below in the description. So how do you feel about these changes? Do you think this is going to help people who are getting the PPP loan? Do you think it's too little of a change, or do you think it's just the right change that we needed? Maybe Shake Shack will be asking for that money back now since they've made all these changes, and it looks like a lot of the complaints they had before have been addressed. So let us know how you feel about these changes. Next thing I want to talk to you about is reopening American businesses. This is taking place in a big way in the month of June, and which is when I'm filming this video. New York City has finally beginning to open. This is big news. New York City is finally opening today, as a matter of fact, today being June 9th. We're opening up businesses today, and they're working their way into phase one. But they had to reach 7 metrics before opening up, which if you haven't heard what these metrics are, I'll leave it down below in the description so you can see what actual changes needed to happen before they got into phase one. While they're moving into phase one, states like Texas already moved into phase three, which is pretty much getting very close to full, getting back to the way we were before this pandemic hit. So Texas is way more advanced than the reopening process. If you're watching this and you're from Texas, leave it down below. Tell us how things are in Texas. Now, New York City has actually estimated that they've lost about 885,000 jobs, and they will not probably regain these jobs for a very long time. They're estimating that by 2022, they may have close to those amount of jobs back. We'll see more about that in the future. And another big news is that Disney is finally committed to reopening their parks by July 11th, which is great news for the economy, great news for people who have missed out on their family vacation this year. This will be good news, but you will have to wear masks while you're there. If anyone's ever been to Disney, you know how hot and how humid it is in Orlando. So wearing a mask is going to be a very crazy thing. There's going to be hand sanitizer dispensers everywhere, so people who are worried about getting germs, that'll be taken care of. They've really kind of restructured the whole parks. Now, they're not allowing for there to be large crowds. So how do you not have large crowds? Well, number one, they're gonna eliminate their parades. There's not gonna be any parades going on like they usually do. That's one of the big things that Disney does. They're not gonna have their fireworks extravaganza either, which is kind of like the way that they end every night at Disney, which is sad because that's one of the best things. Kids really love those, and those things really stick in your mind. But a question I'm having is, okay, if you got to keep your social distance, there's no crowds. These lines at Disney have always been insane. Where are these lines going to end up now that we have to keep our distance and you're going to not be able to have crowds? These lines, they're going to have to come up with a solution for this. I'm very curious to see if everyone's going to get a speed pass, if everyone could just make an appointment to go on a ride. We'll find out more about that in the future. And they're also going to have cashless transactions. So cashless transactions, I guess they would mean, you know, they're only going to be accepting credit card payments or maybe quick pay payments. But I'm wondering, do you think Disney is capable of possibly getting their own cryptocurrency, maybe a Mickey coin or something like that? Leave it down below in the description and see if maybe it'll make some changes to get a crypto coin for Disney. We'll see about that. All right. So do you think it's too late? Do you think it's been taking cities and counties and states way too long? Leave it down below in the description section. Let us know what you think. Do you think it's been way too long, or do you think we're opening up appropriately? If you don't know where your state sits right now, or if you're curious when your state is going to go back to full capacity, I'm leaving a link down below in the description section where you can type in the state in which you live, and you can see when your state is opening or what you're allowed to do as a business owner, or what businesses are opening up in your state. So check that out down below in the description. Next thing I want to talk to you about is the jobs report. The jobs report is something that everyone is looking towards because, as you know, we're hitting record unemployment. We haven't seen this much unemployment since the Great Depression. So everyone right now is asking themselves, you know, where is the market heading? Where is the economy going? So the jobs report that was just released on June 5th, last Friday, was actually better than expected. We saw a 13.3% jobless rate, which is a lot less than what people were predicting. But here comes the but: it was misinterpreted. And what I mean is that the Bureau of Labor Statistics is in charge of making sure that they get their numbers correct when it comes to who's working and who's not working. They claim that in the month of May, we have a 13.3% jobless rate, and the economy gained 2.5 million jobs. But the problem with that is that they were not counting the people correctly. They were called misclassification. So let me explain to you what happened. So because of the jobless claims number, which was better than expected, the Dow rallied over 1,000 points on Friday, got us up over 27,000 points. Insane. We're in a tail end of a pandemic, I guess you want to call it, and our stock market is at record highs. This is crazy. I'm not sure if you guys agree with me. Let me know how you feel about that. But the Bureau of Labor Statistics misclassified some workers as employed, not at work. So what this means is that they should have been classifying these people as unemployed or temporarily laid off. But the problem is that this is not the first time that they've made this mistake. This is the third month in a row in which they've misclassified people. Now, I don't know about you, but this is a government agency, and I guess you get away with a lot more mistakes, I guess you would call it, in government agencies. But if this was my employee or this was my department that continuously for 3 months straight making the same mistake, I think we have a problem here. We would definitely be making changes, and we would definitely be taking care of the issue the first time around, not 3 months in a row. Let me know how you feel about that. I think this was almost done on purpose, maybe to an extent. I'm not 100% sure of that. So the actual misclassification was off by 3%. So they claimed that the jobless rate was 13.3%. So if you make that adjustment, it's actually 16.3%. So 16.3% of the available workforce is out of work right now. In your areas, it may be higher than that, and in some areas it may be less than that, but across the country we're looking at 16% plus in the month of May. So what that actually did was, it was also wrong for April. So in April, when the jobs report and real unemployment was 16, it should have really been 19% in April. So that's, but the thing is that since April to May, we've actually gained 3% back in the labor force, which is big. It's a big win, because people are getting back to work. This month in June is going to be a real game changer for us. Whatever happens this month is going to really set the tone for the rest of the summer and the rest of the year, because now businesses are starting to reopen. The majority of the states are now starting to go into a more gradual opening process. So we're going to see this month how many people actually get hired back. So stay tuned for some updates on that. Now, some of the speculations out there that I've been hearing is that these numbers were skewed on purpose to make Donald Trump look better and make it look like he's doing a great job. We know we're in an election year this year, so I can't confirm or deny that, but those are some of the speculations that we've been hearing. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say about that. Leave it down below and we can have a discussion about it and see what everyone is thinking. Now, the response that the BLS actually has given us is the following. So this is what they've said, and we obviously they came clean and they came out and said, yeah, this was our fault. This is something that we had as an oversight. You know, no one had to bring it to their attention. They came out and said it themselves, so we'll give them that much credit. But what they said is that they've had an adjustment to their workflow. Obviously, everybody has, because of the whole pandemic. Everyone has been having to work remotely and all this stuff. So they're blaming it on their workflow, and they haven't been giving their interviewers clear enough guidance. Okay, so they're taking responsibility in a way, but they're also blaming it on the boots on the ground people, which is a little bit unfair, because I'm sure if we interviewed those people, we would hear a totally different story. Now, it's insane how less bad news can make the markets rally the way they did. And that's exactly what we saw on Friday. The markets went insane. We haven't seen anything like this. It almost seems like we're living in a twilight zone. You know, we have 16% unemployment, but the market's at an all-time high. If you would have told any analyst this or any market investor this information a year ago, we'll have 16% unemployment, but we'll be at record highs in the market, I think they would probably put you in an insane asylum, because that's not how things normally work. But like I said, either way, we are seeing a steady increase in rehiring people and bringing people back to work. There are other people who are stating also that they're counting people who are underemployed as employed. They're also counting people who have taken gig economy jobs as being employed. So the real number could be much higher than what we're currently seeing right now. So also, that's something to take consideration. Now, the question I have for you, do you think this was done intentionally? Do you think this was something that the BLS actually did to prop up the market, to make Donald Trump look better? Or do you think this was an accident? I'd love to know how you guys feel about this. I know it's a big oops and a big boo-boo. If it was someone working for me making this kind of mistake, not once but three times, I think I'd have to fire that person. So let us know how you feel about that. Now, in conclusion, this is something that I'm going to continue to give you. I'm going to give you the business news, the economy, whatever is going on and trending that's important to you as a business owner. I think it's important because not a lot of us, enough of us, get this information in an unfiltered way. I know we get a lot of the information from the media, the mainstream media, which a lot of times, as you know, is just sugar-coated. So this forum allows us to actually have a discussion about what's going on. Also want to talk to you guys about some of my personal things that I have available for you as business owners. As a real estate agent, as a real estate investor, I've been involved in over 2,000 transactions in my lifetime. So if you're interested in learning about real estate investing, or you want to bring your real estate business to the next level, I do have heavily discounted courses that you could learn from at your own pace, at your own time. I'll leave the links to those down below in the description section. Like I said, guys, this is something I've basically created my career around, and I've trained thousands of agents through group trainings and group sessions and one-on-ones. So if you guys ever have any questions about that, feel free to ask or you take one of my courses. We've also just revamped our entire website, so now you can go to our website and basically see how we can work together, whether that's through coaching, through one of our courses, through mentoring, or even if you just want to see what kind of books I'm reading, what kind of books I recommend reading if you're in business or an entrepreneur. All that information is going to be linked down below. You can check out our website. Let us know what kind of changes you think we should still make, because we're still in the process of making it 100% finished. And you know, that's basically what I've been working on when I haven't been making these videos. Also, guys, if you're enjoying this video and you want to be updated every time we bring you some new business and economy news, please consider subscribing to this channel. Hit the notification bell. That way you can be alerted, because that's the way YouTube works. You will not see this unless you hit that notification bell. And share this with a friend, guys. And most importantly, give this video a like, because if you like this video, more people such as yourself can have access to this great information. Only if you want to be a part of our live discussion tomorrow, we're having an EIDL Q&A, basically ask me anything, even if it's PPP, stimulus, business, any kind of question you have, guys. Tomorrow we're doing a live session, 12 p.m., so bring your questions. That's 12 p.m. Eastern, right on this channel. If you are interested in attending that, leave a message down below in the comment section. We'll send you the direct link for tomorrow's live session. And thank you, guys. Also, if you haven't seen the video I did recently on Starbucks and why they can't seem to pay their rent, you're going to want to watch that video right here. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.